柬泰国投资促进委员会副秘书长蔡英先生讲话，他发言的主题是 ASEAN 框架下，泰国具备哪些投资优势？ลำดับต่อไปเขาเรียกเชิญคุณชานินชาววังชาวจางค่ะรองเลขาธิการสำนักงานคณะกรรมการส่งเสริมการลงทุนเพิ่มรายได้ในหัวข้อดีของการลงทุนในประเทศไทยภายใต้กับความตัวลงอาเซียนมีอะไรบ้างคะ
Executive, all executive, honorable guests and ladies and gentlemen, good morning. First of all, I would like to thank to the Beijing Business People Association Thailand who have to organize this event and have me to present to in the event today. So my presentation today about the opportunity to invest and opportunity of investment in Thailand. Second to the ASEP program. Ladies and gentlemen, okay. If we're talking about ASEP, maybe it is a big a marketplace that could have a biggest market size among the other pre-trade agreement area. And for this is already open the opportunity for investment for the Chinese businessman. At the statistic in the past, the investment in Thailand from China is growing very fast. Now already top three of the investor who invest in Thailand and the most fastest growing of the country who come to invest in Thailand. And this is the, you can see the company who already stand in Thailand, many big company already in Thailand and the investment from China to Thailand is a variety of sector. Maybe start from automotive, metal parts and machinery, and also the energy sector. The relation between Thailand to go to all investment in China also have some investment that we go to invest in China. This is the sample of the company from Thailand to invest in overseas. Now come to see the advantage of investment in Thailand under the ASEP program that you can see that Thailand has the population on most certain 70 million people and Thailand is the location that have the ease of doing business and we already developed the infrastructure for investor. And we have a low cost of living and office space. That's why many companies come to set up in Thailand. And with the strong support from the government, Thailand could support investor for better business and can compete in the market. Thailand have a good infrastructure and connectivity to China and also ASEAN countries so that Chinese businessman can have Thailand add the connectivity to the ASEAN market and also other market in the world as well. So we have a deep support that already in world class standard and especially right now Thailand just improved the rail system. In the past, the transport system in Thailand the main transport is on the trucks. So, but the government, recent government just improved the rail system that to be the future of transportation for the product. So this is challenge and good opportunity for Chinese businessmen because you already have a good experience how to use the utilize the rail system for the transportation of product and integrate together. And so it means in the future we need the system for logistic equipment or everything that can integrate the transport system from the normal system to the rail system. And you can bring your experience to Thailand, and this is the, your opportunity. And Thailand also have many industrial estate that prepare for the investor who would like to come to Thailand, and all industrial estate have the world class standard. So to make sure that all utility, everything that will have a good quality for the investor. And especially right now, the government develop the eastern area like a special zone for investor for high tech industry. So we already construct the world class standard of infrastructure for the investor. And also we already invest the zone that for investor to come to Thailand to do to utilize on R&D for high tech industry, for digital industry, and medical hub, and also aerospace industry. This is the future for the industry of Thai people of Thailand. Come to the investment policy. So the board of investment is the agency who respond to promote investment to Thailand, and we provide executive information, comprehensive information for the investor who would like to come to invest in Thailand, and we can be partner of investor. And we have the three office in China that can support the Chinese government of a businessman. And especially in Beijing, we also have the office there, so you can contact them. The board of investment is only the agency can provide the corporate tax incentive exemption to investors. So please feel free to contact us, to coordinate with us to help you to invest in Thailand. And for tax incentive, we can provide corporate income tax exemption up from 3 years up to 15 years. And with our program, we accept the 100% foreigner can own the company in Thailand, and you can buy the land if you are under the BOI program. So and we also have the program to facilitate the your visa and work permit for you to easier to come to enter into Thailand and work in Thailand. The tax incentive, as I said, that we can provide from 3 years up to 15 years. But okay, it depends on the what kind of the business you are going to invest in Thailand. And we have our system, we have the industry rate first. You can get the basic incentive from by your industry, and you can get an additional incentive if you do something more like you have the R&D expenditure or you locate in the certain area that we would like to have you there. Come to the your opportunity to invest in Thailand. Thailand have the 12 target industry for attracting the FDI into the Thailand. We have the target for agriculture and food. We name our country as the kitchen of the world. So we are welcome the investor to come to develop the food industry more and more in Thailand. And tourism, you know well that many Chinese tourists have been to come to Thailand. And automotive is the major sector of Thailand that we would like to develop to next generation of automotive, like electric vehicle. And we expect that the Chinese friend will come to invest more on electric vehicle. And this is a good opportunity for you, because the government will really have very strong support for electric vehicle, because we would like to solve our pollution problem, and we would like to reduce the carbon from in Thailand. So the electric vehicle is the key factor that we can meet that target. And another one is electronics. So Chinese already good in electronic and 5G equipment or everything that. I think this is your opportunity for come to Thailand. And another one I would like to introduce is the healthcare and digital. So under RCEP, maybe we already open for the Chinese programmer and software who enjoy service for software service in Thailand. So please come to see us and to help us to improve the facility on digital. Come to a little bit more in healthcare to let you know more that Thailand, actually we are the biggest medical tourism market. So many foreigners come to Thailand to got a practice from the doctor in the Thai hospital. So this market is growing and growing. It means they need more medical device and medical supply. So pharmaceutical, something like that. So we need to promote the investor to come to produce medical device, pharmaceutical and medical service more in Thailand in order to supply to the hospital business in Thailand. And come to digital industry, we would like to promote digital industry to transform the business in Thailand to be digital organization. So we need a lot of partner to come to Thailand to develop the system for Thai company. So this is a big challenge. And as I mentioned earlier, 5G technology is coming, and actually in Thailand, we already, the telecom provider already provide the 5G service, but just waiting for the system to install, to support to their customer to get the better efficiency from 5G. And the 5G technology, I think China is the leader in the world. So you have more chance to do business on this sector in Thailand. And another one is education. Thailand also already deregulation the law that allow foreign educational institution to set up to in Thailand to offer service for education for people in Thailand to get the knowledge in new technology and anything that relate for the new business. So if you interested about how to come to set up business in Thailand, my office, the Board of Investment, already prepare ourselves to support you. So we have the facility to support all investors to come to Thailand. In Bangkok, we have the one-stop investment service center that can provide comprehensive service that we will connect for all to all agency related for you to service to you in one place. And another thing is we provide the service in digital. So that means you can submit the application to my office anytime, anywhere. So you just submit online by our e-service. And many procedure work that you connect to the investor, we are going to develop more to get the digital service provide for the investor. And another thing, the last thing I would like to introduce you is Smart Visa. Smart Visa is the special visa for the investor, for the talent, for startup to come to do something in Thailand. So in normal visa, you may get the visa 1 year and continue or 2 year and continue. And you, in order to work in Thailand, you apart from visa, you have to get a work permit. But Smart Visa, if integrate all together, it means this visa already input work permit. And we will provide you 4 years, maximum 4 years. So it will be more convenient for investor to come to Thailand. And with this visa, no need to get the re-entry permission. So this visa already complete everything. And another special thing is normal visa in Thailand for foreigner to come to Thailand and get a work permit. You can do job, do work in Thailand already expat who get that visa, but their relative like a spouse and a daughter, son who come together to stay in Thailand cannot work in Thailand. But this smart visa allow spouse and also their children that have or qualify to work in Thailand with their visa as well. So this is the service we are going prepare to support the investor from our partner from China. And I hope we will have a chance to support you more. And especially as I said that the special sector that we are very interested from China is electric vehicle, digital technology, something like that. And if you have anything that we can support you, you can contact to us in our head office in Bangkok. And actually we have office in three office in China. You can see in detail from our website how to contact them. Thank you very much.
感谢蔡英先生的演讲。投资泰国的具优势在 ASEAN 框架下得以更为清晰。好，欢迎大家参加会议。那接下来呢，我们将有请泰国盘古银行资深执行副总裁高尚先生讲话。他发言的主题是。后疫情时代 ASEAN 框架下泰国经济发展趋势及未来商业新模式大家到拜考点车混搞撒混的不让干嘛干啊无所那哈他那看公开拜爱那火靠那有轮干帕他那但是的给把地台罗汤出了给百买来阿那口拍的 ASEAN 那一两口味是高卡
萨迪卡ครับท่านหวังลี่ผิงท่านอัครราชทูตที่ปรึกษาฝ่ายเศรษฐกิจและพาณิชย์สถานเอกอัครราชทูตสหรัฐประชาชนจีนประจำประเทศไทยท่านชิยาวันจงวัฒนาอัครราชทูตฝ่ายพาณิชย์สถานเอกอัครราชทูตไทยณกรุงปักกิ่งคุณชัยธนิชานันนายกสมาคมนักธุรกิจปักกิ่งประเทศไทยท่านหลี่เผิงผู้แทนสภาส่งเสริมการค้าระหว่างประเทศแห่งประเทศจีนประจำประเทศไทยคุณรงศักดิ์พุทธพรมงคลประธานสมาพันธ์หอการค้าไทยจีนคุณชนินขาวจันทร์ท่านรองเลขาธิการสำนักงานคณะกรรมการส่งเสริมการลงทุนท่านผู้ประกอบการไทยจีนทุกท่านผู้มีเกียรติทุกคนครับผมขอพูดเป็นภาษาอังกฤษนะครับGood mornings, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor to be invited to participate in the China International Fair for Trade in Service 2021 and sharing my view about the prospect of the Thai economy and the future of businesses under ASEAN in the post-COVID-19 era. Over the past year and a half,COVID-19 have become the greatest challenges to all governments around the world, and its impact have been felt by the people at all levels. Many, in fact, millions have become unemployed, have to change their jobs, and have to relocate back to their homes, especially those in the tourism sectors. Even at this moment, many countries, including Thailand,continue to fight with COVID and try very hard to restart their economy. So today, an opportunity to talk about the future of businesses under ASEAN in the post-COVID-19 era is a chance for me to look beyond the present, reflect on what is awaiting us in the future, and articulate on how to prepare ourselves well so that we can prosper together. Given limited time,I would like to focus on only three topics. The future of Asia in the post-COVID era, the prospect of the Thai economy, and finally, initiative that China and Thailand can work together to prosper. For the first topic, let me begin by stating that I have a great confidence in the future of Asia. The post-COVID era,will be the era of Asia. It will be the era where China and Thailand can prosper together. Before COVID, the center of gravity for the world economy is already shifting toward Asia. After COVID, the trend will continue with China, India, and Southeast Asia becoming the most exciting area for businesses. I am very certain of these futures. The size of Asia in terms of the number of its population, in terms of its income level, will create one of the most compelling cases that will attract business people around the world to our regions. Any company that would like to be truly successful over the next 20 years, it must have Asia plan as part of its core strategy. Our recent completion of ASEP make this case even stronger. ASEP, including all the key economy in Asia and its close neighbors such as Australia and New Zealand, its 15 member states together account for 30% of the world population, 30% of the world GDP, and is the largest trading bloc in the world. At this point in time, although India decided not to participate at the last minute, I'm very confident that eventually India will join ASEP and will make ASEP even greater. Let me move on to my second topic, the prospect of the Thai economy. Although the Thai economy has been greatly impacted by the spread of COVID over the past couple months, COVID also provides us with new business opportunities. Like the case of SARS in early 2000s that allowed China to embark on e-commerce businesses and brought about the rise of Alibaba and Tencent, COVID has fast-forwarded our digital adoption and transformation. What would usually take a decade to do has been accomplished in a short period of this 1.5 years. With COVID, e-commerce platform, delivery service, cashless payment, social media marketing, as well as those technology that enable us to work anywhere have become very well accepted. This rapid digital adoption have changed our business landscape forever and opened many great opportunities for businesses. So as an economist, I can feel that once Thailand get COVID under control without our vaccination program, that by year end, we vaccinate more than 85% of our populations. We can safely open our economy, our border, and our tourism businesses once again. With that, we will restart our economy and bring in the post-pandemic boom that will rapidly transform our economy for the following decades. I would like to share with you some pictures of the project in Thailand that will be completed over the next 4 to 5 years. Can I have these? This is the first page that I would like to share with you. Over the next 5 years, Bangkok metropolitan area will complete 10 lines of the subway. This plan has been there for the past 15 years, but over the last government, we have been bidding out most of these projects. And by the next 5 years, we will be able to complete most of this subway system. It will change Bangkok forever and it will make the transportation and the traffic system in Bangkok change like never before. The next picture, please. We also work on the dual track train program. Next page. We also, this double track program and also other infrastructure program like the motorway, the airport system will change the logistics system in Thailand. On the right picture, you can see that our plan to make sure that all the traffic of the double track train will be laid out across Thailand and to the border, to Myanmar, to Laos, to Cambodia, and also to Malaysia. So it means that in the future, the logistics system will be cheaper in Thailand. The next picture, please. We also working on the project that Deputy Secretary General of the BOI have talked to you already. This is called the EEC projects. Next page, please. In these projects, we have planned a lot of key basic infrastructure that will transform our eastern economic corridor. The high-speed rail link from Bangkok to Rayong, the new airport at Utapao, the new deep-sea port extension at Lam Chabang and Mataput, several of the smart cities, one innovation district at the EECI, and we also have been working on the 5G projects to making sure that 80% of the EEC area will be covered with the 5G capabilities. That will make sure that the EEC players will be one of the most exciting players to do business and for the Chinese company to set up their factory in. Next page, please. We also work on the next projects, which is called the Southern Economic Corridor. This is the connection to the circle on the top, which is the EEC area. The Southern Economic Corridor is the exactly the first place Thailand in touch with the Indian Ocean. With that new deep sea port in the western side of Thailand, we can cut down the time from shipping the product from Lam Chabang port in the EEC area from 12 to 25 days to only 4 to 7 days in the future. This will be definitely important to the economy of Thailand. Next page, please. This project is now well underway with double track train coming from Bangkok, go right to Ranong area. And at the same time, we are working on motorway, also deep sea port and other things that will be established later. And with the addition of the SEC and the EEC together, Thailand will become one of the most exciting places to for production, where you can ship the product both to the Pacific Oceans and also to the Indian Ocean very cheaply. Next page, next page, please. We also planning on the new CBD for Bangkok. Over the next 5 years, we will have a lot of exciting office space coming up. For example, the top left is One Bangkok, is now well underway. The bottom left is Central Dusit area. And the middle one is Bang Sue area, which is already completed. The bottom right is Ache Thiek, which will also housing one of the tallest building in the world. That will be coming up sometime soon. And the top right is the Makassan area. This will be linked with the new high-speed rail link from the Suvarnabhumi Airport. You can go to Makassan area within 15 minutes. Next page, please. The opportunity in the ASEAN is a lot of opportunity I can see. We need a lot of new power plant, new alternative energies, new dam, and also new industrial estate, new real estate projects, and also the tourism sector is second to none. This is the place where a lot of Chinese travelers would like to come. We have focused large proportion of our public investment on upgrading our logistics system. It is a Chinese saying that if you would like to bring prosperity to any place, any cities, any town, give it a logistics system. Logistics will bring prosperity. And to follow the Chinese saying, this is exactly the policy of the Thai government. We have been putting a lot of money in the subway system, in the motorway, in the double track train, in the EEC area, and this will change the prosperity of our country. Once this project completed, Bangkok and Thailand will stand as one of the best places to do business in Southeast Asia regions. For the last topic, that China and Thailand can work together to prosper. Over the past several years, many companies from China are looking for new places to relocate their factory. Given our strategic position in the center of ASEAN, as well as our close cultural tie to China, Bangkok and Thailand will be the best location and the right place for Chinese businesses who would like to enter into Southeast Asia regions. Thailand is at the center of Indochina Peninsula, with good logistic network connecting to Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, Myanmar, and Bangladesh. Together, this is an area of 400 million people with thriving economy, some of them growing at 7%. We are all connected by land and can move material and products freely and effectively. For the people of these CLMVB regions, made in Thailand is associated with made with quality. So producing your product in Thailand can give you a great advantage in this exciting market. Second, we can work together on the Belt and Road Initiative. Thailand will be the most important link connecting Western China and Southern China to ASEAN. Let me show you the picture of the current connectivities. Next picture, please. In this connectivity map, you can see that there are already a road connecting Western China from Kunming to the northern part of Thailand. And this road is already well traveled and it can bring product from the Western China area right down to Bangkok and distribute to the world from Lam Chabang port to the Pacific Ocean. And later on, once we complete the Southern Economic Corridor, the product from Western China from Kunming can go down to Ranong area and ship to India and to Europe very cheaply as well. We also have another link from Nanning, Guangxi, and that also link up to Vietnam and also to Laos and to the northeastern part of Thailand. And it's also very well traveled. So basically, this connectivity is well linked. And Khun Wang Li Ping, Than Wang Li Ping have already talked to you already about the new high-speed rail link from Kunming to Vientiane. And we also hope to connect from Vientiane to Bangkok and to the EEC area and later to the southern part of Thailand. That will making sure that the connectivity from the railroad from China can link up to all Indochina Peninsula and also throughout ASEAN. And we also would like to link to China to the sea network as well. We hope that this will be very important link that we can create together. By December of this year, the high-speed rail link from Kunming to China will come to Vientiane. Lao will be completed and started operation, and we can work together to extend this rail connection to Bangkok and to the rest of ASEAN. So Thailand will be the key exit point for the product from Western China to ASEAN and the world, as I said before. Third, we can create the close link between our Eastern Economic Corridor, our EEC, with the GBA, the Greater Bay Area, and Hong Kong and China. The Greater Bay Area Initiative is one of the most important projects of China, and the EEC is also one of the most important projects of Thailand. We would like to connect these two projects together. So the EEC will be your gateway to ASEAN, and the GBA will be our gateway into China. This will create a strong connection between China and Thailand, as well as make it one of the most important links in the Belt and Road Initiative. Our EEC, once completed, will be one of the most important economic areas within ASEAN. With great infrastructure, second to none, EEC will provide Chinese companies that are looking for a place for their factory location with a new home that will be greatly advantageous to its businesses in ASEAN. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, there are many things that we can do together. What I mentioned today are just merely a few of them. I am very confident that by joining hands, China and Thailand can prosper together in the post-COVID era and create one of the most important economic ties that will be the leading example of others. Thank you.